Cats Diamond Painting. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've joined me here before. Today I am here to do a WIP'n'Chat, which is where I diamond paint and chat and fill you in on what's been up in my world recently. And if you have a project ongoing, if you have a diamond painting or any other kind of craft project or whatever you're doing and you fancy working along with me, that's great. I am working on House on a Cliff. I've got it all set up on my easel already, so you can only see this little section, I'm afraid. But yeah, I'm nearing the end. I have maybe about 2.5 rows to go because I section mine off in rows, as you can see here. So I'm hoping to get this one done within the next week or so, and then I'll be on to a new project. Before I go any further, Sandy Preston, if you are watching, you were the winner of my giveaway for reaching 1,000 subscribers, which I announced in my second Dreams Kitting Up video a couple of weeks back now. I have replied to your comment to let you know. I haven't heard back from you. So yeah, just if you're watching this, drop me an email. My email address is catsdiamondpainting@gmail.com, and then we can get that sorted out. Okay. So today I am going to be working with my Oriloa tray, one of my Oriloa trays. I've recently bought 4. It says Oriloa on the back. And I'm kind of obsessed with these. They're really, really good trays. The reason I'm loving them is that they've been very, very good with my round painting that I've just worked on. And I struggle to find trays that will line up rounds as well as they will line up squares. But this one does a great job. So I thought I'd try it today with squares, as I've finished my latest round painting and put that aside now. And I'm going to be working with my newest pen, which I think has to be probably my favourite pen at the moment as well. This one I bought from La Douceur d'une Plume. She has a Facebook group. So I saw it on there and then it linked to her shop. So I bought that there. And I've got a Diamond Art Club single placer installed. And I have this already loaded. So in my single placer, I have got some Randy's Crafty Corner. I use this in multi-placer and single placer. I like this wax, it's not a wax, this putty a lot. It's not as sticky as some other putties I've been trying, and it doesn't seem to last as long before I need to refill. But because of it not being so sticky, I can generally get away with using it on AB drills, which is really nice rather than having to change pen. And then in my multi-placer, I've got some Abby's Diamond Putty. So this is a brand new, like really recently set up seller on Etsy. And one of the diamond painting Facebook groups that I'm in, someone like discovered this and said, you guys, UK based putty, it's really cheap and easy to get a hold of. And we've been flooding this lady with orders. This was the first one I bought, the peppermint cream. And I've also got sweet peach. And then on the way to me, I think I have black cherry and bubblegum. So those are the 4 flavors she's released so far. Anyway, check her out. It's really good. I like it a lot. Very, very sticky. Keep it away from your ABs. If you're working with this, you want to have the ABs be the last thing you do in the section and use a different pen. But it's really nice. And it's lasting 2 or 3 days of diamond painting easily in my multi-placer. So let's get going. Right, I'm going to work kind of largely right to left, because if I start on the left, I'm just going to have my hand sticking in it, and I hate that. So how is everyone doing today? It's Wednesday here. So my son's at school, my husband's at work, and I just have around an hour or so, maybe a little bit less, before I have to go out. So I'm just getting a little bit of diamond painting done and getting this filmed ready to upload for Friday. It's been a pretty cold week, but it's not looking too bad today. So I'm hoping the school run isn't going to be quite as freezing as it was the last few days. Do you know, I haven't worked on a square painting in 2.5 weeks or so. I kind of feel out of practice, and squares are generally my jam. I'm also sitting at a slightly funny angle in order to be able to film. So I'm quite a way back from the painting compared to how I usually am. I think I need to invest in something that will be better for holding my phone for filming when I'm doing these, like an overhead something or other. I have an iPad stand on like a bendy wire frame, which I have attached to the table, and I use that to hold my iPad while I'm diamond painting, because I always have something on my iPad. I'm either listening to something or watching something. And I did try putting it in there, but it was just too small. So I think I could do the equivalent for a phone, because I'm using my usual stand and that kind of really gets in the way. So then I have to sit quite a way back. It'd be nice to be able to just sit how I normally would and then still be able to film. Anyway, if anyone out there is watching has anything that they think could fit the brief, please do let me know, particularly other YouTubers. I'd love to know what your kit is that you use to film with. I'm pretty basic, really. I basically film on my phone. I'd love at some stage to invest in a better camera, but at the moment I do not have the funds to get a camera that would improve on the quality I get from my phone and have, you know, the other features that I would need. So I'm just using like a stand that I have for that phone, but it's very wobbly. So if I knock it at all, you'll know, because you'll jut around all over the place. And yeah, it gets in my way a lot. I need something that's a little bit less obtrusive, I think. So yeah, let me know what you use. I was trying to do this WIP'n'Chat lying flat on my table. Not me lying flat, the diamond painting. Because I normally work on my easel, but I thought, you know, for a change, for a different angle, I'd try doing it flat. And I could not get a setup to work for love nor money. So yeah. I could do suggestions. I'd love to know what you all use. Oh, these drills are a bit clumped. I might have to get out my new drill grinder in a second. That's another one I've been enjoying. I keep mentioning these accessories I've bought. I have said before, I will be doing a video at some point, probably in the next month, just showing you some of the accessories I've bought recently. Because the past couple of months, I've bought quite a few things that have been really good that I'd quite like to show. That's putties, it's pens, it's trays, it's things like a drill grinder that I finally invested in, because I spent ages thinking, what's the point? I can just mash, you know, when the drills are stuck together, I can just mash them between. I think there's like a bit of wax that must have got scuffed up when I was working it yesterday, because that drill just keeps coming off, keeps sticking on rather, the opposite of coming off. Yeah, I kept thinking, well, I can just mash the drills between two trays. It's fine. I don't need to spend money. And then I figured I'd just give it a go. And it honestly is so much better. Anyways. So, it's nice to be back on this painting. I do really love this one. But then I did also really love Second Dream that I've just finished. I'll have a post review for that one coming up soon. But I'm excited now that this is my last WIP and I will be done with it fairly soon. And then I don't have anything else on the go, which is unheard of for me. I think last year I got into the habit at some points of having, I think I had up to about 5 or 6 WIPs at once. And it kind of overwhelmed me. And I found I was getting fed up of paintings because they'd been ongoing for months with me switching between them. Don't really want to do that anymore, but I also am not averse to having 2 or 3 on the go, so I'm not really sure how I've got down to just the one. But I have my next WIP planned, my next project planned. I know which one I'm going to work on, and probably the one after that as well. And I'll see how I go when I kit it up. I'm being mysterious just in case I change my mind. I don't want to totally commit myself, but I think I know what I'm working on. And once I have got that kitted up and working on it, I'll see how I go and if I want to get another one on the go. I do quite like to have, this is really annoying. This isn't a good advert for this putty today. It was not doing this yesterday. It's probably just because it's a little bit stale. I probably need to change it. Anyways. Yeah, so we shall see. I like to have a couple of different ones on the go because I get bored easily. So I like to have, say, a round and a square or a confetti heavy painting and a less confetti heavy painting. So, yeah. I tell you what, I actually should have reloaded this pen before I started because both of the waxes are feeling a little bit. Yeah, they're just not working as well as they could. I think I'm going to stop there and reload. Luckily, I have them to hand. So I will do my best to show you what I do, but obviously I'm working on an easel. The camera isn't pointing down. It'll be a bit of a struggle to show you properly. I'll hopefully give you an idea. Right. What I'm doing at the moment, by the way, off camera, because I just can't fit, is using a pair of tweezers to just pick the old wax out. That'll do. Okay. So for my Randers putty, first of all, that I'm just going to put straight in my single placer. I know not a lot of people seem to use putties for their single placers, but I do like using this one. So I'm literally just going to stab this like I would wax. So I'll do that on the table. Here we are. And you can see, hopefully, if it comes into frame, focus even. Oh, it doesn't want to focus. But basically, you can see that that's in there. And now for my multi-placer. By the way, I keep these in the fridge. That's one tip I've learned. And I find that helpful to keep them at a good consistency. You may or may not find that helpful depending on your climate. So this is the Abbey's putty. And as you can see, this comes... that's the bit I had before. Right. This is quite thick, right? And you can just stab your multi-placer through it and rock it around. I find that if I do that, it is too full. So my putty will be overflowing out of my multi-placer constantly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to snip a bit off, or you can rip it off with your fingers, whatever you like to do. It's just me being strange and wanting to keep the rest of it neat. So I've got a little piece here, and I'm just going to roll that around in my fingers, squish it out a bit, and squish it into a much thinner shape, like that. Now I'm putting that back down on the release paper that this was packaged in, and now I'm going to roll my multi-placer in this like this until it's filled. I find that that just helps me to avoid having lots of bits of putty sort of trailing out of my multi-placer and sticking to my canvas and my drills. It might mean I need to refill it slightly more often. I'm not sure. I mean, I've done this and then still had a good 3 days diamond painting out of it. But you can see there's not too much overflowing. I'm still going to squish it down a bit. And there will be little bits of overspill that I'll need to deal with, particularly as I'm doing, you know, the first bit of work with it. But it shouldn't be overflowing too much. Okay, let me put those away. So what's been happening here since I last spoke to you? Well, we had half-term holiday for my son. If you're not British and you don't know what that means, it's a week's holiday in the middle of each of the 3 school terms of the year. Just as a sort of break, as a rest for the kids, good chance to regroup. So he had that. There's always one in February. It's the second week back now I'm filming this. So I'm going to be talking about things from a couple of weeks ago, but I haven't had a chance to do a chatty video. So I figured I would just, you know, go back in time a bit. I am struggling a little bit with this angle. I really must sort out a better camera angle. Anyways, so the Friday night at the start of half term, we finally went and did my birthday treat for my husband that he'd bought me. And my birthday was in January, we had a couple of false starts where we tried to go and I was ill and then my son was ill. So we tried to go a few times and it didn't really work out. But we had it planned now for this Friday of half term and it worked. We got there. So yeah, oh gosh, look at the static in that one. These drills have not been great, to be fair. I've mentioned in the past that I spoke to customer service about it and Diamond Art Club have totally set it right. They would have sent me new drills if it was just a few colours. I said, you know, don't worry, it's kind of most colours to varying degrees, and they gave me a really nice credit on my account. Which of these has got? One of these has got a little bit sticking off it that I can see once it's on here. And I can't work out which, so I'm just going to pick them both off. Plus, I've got a little bit of overspill from my putty. This is all a bit chaotic so far today, isn't it? In fact, I'm going to just squish this single placer down on a drill. Just like this. And it will squish some of the excess out. Make it less likely that that's going to shed bits of putty everywhere. Right. Okay. Hopefully we can get going now. So yeah, we went to this really nice restaurant. That was my birthday treat. It has, I believe, a Michelin star, which I'm fairly sure is an international concept, but just in case you don't know what it is, I'll explain as best I can because I don't really understand. But they go around and assess restaurants, and chefs can win Michelin stars. And it just it's a mark of quality, basically. If a place has a Michelin star, it's going to be pretty good. So, yes, we went there. We all went. The nice thing about it was they actually had a kids menu. And if you think about fancy restaurants, not many places have a kids menu. So it was a nice experience for my son to come along and join in. Sorry, still picking bits of spare putty off. So we drove down there. It was at Newbury, sort of an hour's drive away in Friday afternoon traffic, so not too bad. And it's a lovely chilled atmosphere there. We sat in the lounge area and had a few drinks. I had the most gorgeous Bellini. It's like Prosecco and peach puree. Oh, I don't know exactly how they made it, but it was stunning. And then we had our food, which was gorgeous. So I had, let me see, I looked this up because I knew what I chose off the menu, but I couldn't remember all the bits. So I looked it up. And for a starter, I had a partridge breast with a sweet corn and bacon salsa and a tarragon polenta cake and chicory and parsley. So there's all sorts of stuff going on. You know what it's like with fine dining when you get like really small portions and there's just, it sounds like loads, but there's just a tiny bit of everything on the plate. So that was lovely. Really enjoyed that. I don't remember if I've ever had parsley. I've definitely had parsley. Pheasant before. Partridge. Oh my goodness. If I had a brain, I'd be dangerous. I can't talk today. I have been practicing multi-placing sideways, like for ones like this, by the way, but I don't think I'm going to risk it the way this is going today. I'm just going to single place along here. So I had that, and then I had a ribeye steak with béarnaise sauce, which is lovely. And they had a few vegetarian options, and they had a vegan menu. My husband, I think, ordered off the vegan menu. He's only vegetarian, but quite often will order off vegan menus as well, because a lot of places prioritize vegan recipes as they're more versatile and will serve both, if you know what I mean. So he had a bit more choice from there. My son had like sort of breaded pork dippers with a barbecue sauce and a chicken burger, and then he had a chocolate fondant. I will say he didn't actually enjoy any of it that much, apart from the chocolate fondant. He's not a bad eater for his age, and he was really excited to try it and have the experience. But I think, like, he read those things on the menu and thought, oh, they sound like things that I would have. But when they were served in a sort of fancier style than he was used to, yeah, he wasn't so keen. But he tried them and, you know, it was really nice to all go together. So that was the Friday night. And then the Saturday, oh, I'm not sure. I don't need to go by day by day, do I? There's probably plenty of days where I didn't really even do that much, to be honest. The Monday of half term, my son went away for the night to stay with his grandparents, my husband's parents. They like to have him to stay in the school holidays if they can. So that was nice. He got to go and do really exciting things. He went to a wildlife park, which is absolutely his jam. You know, he loves animals. He wants to study zoology when he's older and then go on to be a zookeeper. So he went there, and then they went to a mini golf place, I think, as well. And he had the night with them. So it was a nice bit of alone time for my husband and I as well. Of course, it didn't really go to plan. So we went for a little walk in the afternoon, went and had a coffee, and that was nice. Just walked up the road to our nearest sort of little town centre. And then we'd picked up, so Marks and Spencer's in the UK is a really nice food shop. They're more expensive, but they do really nice quality stuff. We didn't want to spend the money of going out for a meal or getting takeaway, but it was the day before Valentine's Day. So we went in and got their Valentine's Day offer. So they did, it was £20 and you got a starter, a main, a side, a dessert, and a bottle of Prosecco or wine. So it was quite good, you know, like when it went through the till, it said it would have been £32.50. And we paid 20. So we thought that would be a nice way to eat something a bit more special and nice at home without the expense of a takeaway. So we did that. These ones won't come off. It's just where, again, because this putty is quite fresh in here, there's a little bit of overspill still, and I don't want to push down too hard in case the putty comes off, because if it sticks to the canvas, it's really hard to get off, obviously, because it's sticky thing meets sticky thing. So let's just trim down these edges a bit. Yeah, so they were like cheese souffle tartlet type things for starter. They were very nice. In fact, that was the highlight, I think. And then we had, so we got the steak from the offer and then picked up a vegetarian steak for my husband and had them with garlic butter. And I think we got like a potato dauphinoise to have on the side, because we would have had chips, but the chips that they had in the offer had beef dripping that they were cooked in. So they were no good. And then the dessert, it was like a sort of millionaire's shortbread pot type thing. Anyway, it was all very nice. Do you remember in my last chatty video, I was talking about how when we went out for my husband's belated birthday meal, I'd felt really strange afterwards. Like I had, my heart was racing and I felt very sick and just had a really unpleasant night. Well, I sort of had that again. So we made the best of it. We sat and watched some shows that we don't normally get a chance to watch. And we watched a film, in fact, as well. What film did we watch? Oh yeah, it was really good, but I can't remember the name of it. I'll try and look it up and put it on. It was like this like comedy whodunit type thing, sort of Agatha Christie style in a way, but comedy. I'll look up the name and put it on the screen. So we did that. But then when I went to bed, I was not feeling good. And it was just another night like the previous week or 2 weeks ago. I can't remember how long ago it was, but it was odd that it was happening again. So the rest of half term week, I was like on and off feeling a bit weird. and having to take it very easy, really. Oh, goodness. Right. I'm going to stop mentioning it because it's boring, but I really am going to sort out this camera angle by next time because I'm struggling with how far away I'm sitting from this. I'd never, ever get any diamond paintings done if I went at this pace the whole time. So, yeah, I spent the whole week just having sort of periods where I'd feel nauseous, periods of like digestive issues, feeling really bloated, all of that kind of thing. It was strange. But anyway, we got on with things. So my son came back from his grandparents on the Tuesday and he went straight back out again with a friend because he'd been invited to go bowling. So they did that all after, well, they went there and they did some other things the afternoon. And then that friend is on the same football team as my son. So the friend's parents took him to football and we caught up with him again. Football training, that is. And then the next day, that same friend came to our house because they needed childcare for him, basically. So we said we'd have him for the day. And my husband managed to get a bit of time off work. Well, he rearranged some things because he's lucky enough to be in a job where he's very much in control of his own schedule. So he arranged some things and pushed them back to the next day. And he took the boys trampolining because I am too achy and creaky and unfit to trampoline. I don't know if you've ever been or if you know what I'm talking about. It's this thing. In Britain, the past few years, it's become a really popular thing. You get like these big warehouse type buildings that turn into an indoor trampoline park. And they're really popular with kids for obvious reasons. And there'll be like inflatables and foam things that they can bounce off. And yeah, anyway, they did that and had a great time. And I think they went to play football afterwards as well. So yeah, it was a good day for everyone. I can't remember what I did. I probably sat at home and diamond painted, to be honest. Rested up because I was still intermittently feeling weird. We rested up on Thursday. I think it was the only day of the whole half term that my son didn't have anything planned. And I think if you're on holiday from school, it's really nice to have lots of activities and see friends and go out and do things. But it's also important to have some time to actually just sit at home and rest. So the two of us had a really quiet day while my husband was out working, which was lovely. And then the Friday we packed up and went to Cardiff for the weekend to see my family. So I am one of four children. I have two sisters and a brother, all a bit older than me. I'm very much the baby of the family. And my sisters both live in Cardiff and my brother lives in, I think it still counts as Somerset. Maybe it's Dorset. I don't know. Anyway. So we had planned in November to all get together, the four of us siblings, for a catch-up day because we don't see that much of each other, you know. And if we do catch up, it'll generally be at family events and there's other people around too, like all of our kids and parents and stuff. And it's nice now and again to just have some time, just us four siblings, to have a really good catch up. So we'd planned to do that in November. And then one of my sisters, well, she fought at the time, she'd broken her foot. It turned out, I think, to be a really bad sprain, but she couldn't drive because they were supposed to come to where I live in Oxford that time. So we'd rescheduled, and we rescheduled for this weekend at the end of half term. So we drove over to Cardiff and then Friday evening, we were having a lovely evening with my parents. My dad in particular really likes sitting in the living room playing music videos through YouTube on the TV very, very loudly. And he absolutely loves having an evening with one or several of his kids doing that and sort of taking it in turns to put music on. So he'd like long planned for us to do that. He'd got beers in for him and my brother and all the rest. So we did that for a bit and it was really nice. And then I started to feel really ill again. So yeah, I don't know what is going on with me. I've spoken to a doctor about it this week, but anyway. Basically, I was sitting there quietly watching videos, so I wasn't doing anything even remotely strenuous. And I suddenly just felt really strange. I felt nauseous. I felt hot and cold. I just felt really kind of out of it. And I guess I must have been sitting quietly for a while, because people noticed and asked if I was okay, and I explained. My dad checked my blood pressure and it soared really, really high. Not like critical high, like you need medical care right now, but high enough that it's like, yeah, you really need to get this checked out. And the thing is, I've had issues with blood pressure for a while. It's very much up and down. I have times when it's fine and then times when it goes really quite high again and freaks me out. But I've never previously felt weird at a time when it was high, if you know what I mean. Like, it was high when I had COVID, and that makes sense because I had an infection. But this was, you know, I felt pretty well and I was sitting there, and then this feeling just came over me. So yeah, it was really unpleasant. It took a while to pass, and I had like these horrible jelly legs, like really strange, and I could feel that my heart was racing. And I have an Apple Watch that checks my pulse, so when I looked, it was indeed really high. So it was a shame because, I mean, it ended my evening, really. I went to bed soon after that. And then the next day was our big meetup as siblings, and obviously I wasn't really on my best form. I had to take it very easy because a meetup in my family means going drinking. So we were going on basically a little pub crawl for the day. But it didn't seem like a good idea to drink lots of wine. You know, my blood pressure was still up and I was still periodically just having, like, nothing as bad as the Friday, but I'd just get a wave of this feeling and not feel good. And I would be conscious of my heart kind of thudding, and then I'd check my watch and it would be high. So yeah, we went out, and I felt mostly okay. My dad was sort of on standby at home, ready and willing to come pick me up if I needed to duck out. But I made it through the day and had a really nice time catching up with my siblings. Sort of discussed all of our news and set the worlds to right, you know. You know how it goes. We had a meal out as well. We had some very nice burgers. So it was a good day. I did feel quite freaked out. Whenever these things would kind of come over me, and I felt really wiped out as well, really, really tired. So it was a shame. Hopefully we'll manage another catch up sometime soonish, and I will not be falling apart for it. I actually told my siblings that I've been doing this YouTube and everything. I've kept it pretty private. I don't tend to tell people I know in real life. Only my immediate family knows, because I feel really self-conscious about it. But, you know, we're filling each other in on our lives. So I told them about it. Both my sisters, like, instantly subscribed to the channel, I think, and, like loads of videos. I told them not to watch them. They were like, oh, I'll watch them. I said, don't watch. I'll be so embarrassed. So hopefully they haven't, but just in case they're here, hi guys. Anyway, we went back to my parents' house, and my mum had made a nice soup, and we had a nice quiet evening, another early night. So yeah, I didn't have much energy at all. I went to bed with my son, in fact. Mind you, he goes to bed later than he should, so that's probably not as early as you're thinking. He's a night owl like his parents. The Sunday. Oh, I should say, by the way, that my husband and my son did come back to Cardiff with me, and they had a really nice day seeing some cousins and hanging out with one of my sister's husbands. Oh, just dropped my pot of drills, luckily with the lid on. This Sunday, we went out on a little adventure. So the Saturday morning, my husband and son had gone to a nearby place with my dad to have breakfast. And my son had seen a sign in the window for a place called Castell Coch. So that's Welsh, if you're wondering why it sounds strange. It means Red Castle. And it is this place sort of just outside Cardiff. And it looks like, I mean, I always used to call it the fairy tale castle growing up. Whenever we drove past it, like, oh, that's the fairy tale castle. Because it looks really otherworldly. Because it was very much built like that. It was built in the 1800s by the Marquis of Bute, who's, I don't know, some, you know, noble person living in the Cardiff area. And it was built in the 1800s, but it was built in the style of a sort of medieval castle. The outside, I mean, I don't know what that was supposed to represent, because it really looks like something out of a fairy tale. It's really cool. If you're ever anywhere near Cardiff in Wales, UK, you should go check it out. Anyway, my son really wanted to see it, so we drove out there. Went around with these little audio guides and learned lots of things about it, which was interesting. It's decorated really chaotically. And then there's all features like a medieval drawbridge. So you got to see what that looks like on the inside. And like, they'd even built things like arrow slits. And I think they had something that my son was really intrigued by called a murder hole, which was basically a hole in the floor that actual medieval castles would have had, because if they were under siege, they would have done things like drop boiling oil through the holes. And this castle was built long after things were fought in that way, but they really stayed faithful to that kind of thing. We climbed up the towers and saw their bedrooms and stuff. The Marquis, the man, the lord of the house, as it were, his bedroom was quite understated, actually. And then his wife had this room up in the tower, and it was really big and open and round. And yeah, I could not imagine sleeping in a room like that. My sleep issues could never, I'd feel too exposed. I don't think it was their primary residence. I think it was like a hunting lodge or something. They were probably very, very wealthy and had multiple homes, you know. The nobility. So that was a fun morning. It was a really nice, pretty day as well. You know, one of those nice winter days with a clear blue sky, and we were up in the hills basically, so we could see a long way. It was lovely. Really nice suggestion to go up there from my son. And we got back. What did we do? Oh, my mum had made us a Sunday lunch. A traditional British roast. I don't know what it's like in other countries. In the UK, a lot of people do a roast dinner on a Sunday. My family, like my little family, my husband, my son, and I don't tend to do it. We do sometimes, but we don't do it every week. We don't do it most weeks even. But often when we see family, that will be dinner on a Sunday. So that was very nice. It was nice to be cooked for. What I mean, I'm not very good at doing it sideways. I was getting quite good doing it round with round drills on Second Dream, and I've got to adapt my technique for squares, because it's really nice to be able to multi-place both ways. But I think a lot of it is also because I'm sitting at a distance. Anyway, after lunch we headed home, because it was the last day of half term. So I figured it would be nice for my son to get home and have an evening to relax. It was a fairly long journey. There seemed to be all sorts of accidents and issues along the motorway. In fact, we drove past this car at one point and it was literally on fire. Like, the bottom of it was on fire and there were people standing nearby. And then when we got home, I looked it up, and apparently it had closed the whole motorway for a while after that, which doesn't surprise me, because when we passed, it was just starting. But yeah, I dread to think what happened afterwards. I hope that no one got hurt. I mean, everyone was out of the cars, so I'm sure that people were at a safe distance. But yeah, not a fun way to spend your Sunday afternoon, eh? Standing by the side of the motorway with your car on fire. So that was our half term. We just had a very, well, I rather had a very quiet week then after that. I just wanted to rest up, give my body every chance I could to recover. I was monitoring my blood pressure and it was still quite high, but the rest of it tailed off. I wasn't having the bouts of nausea or that kind of thing. I was just really, really wiped out. Like the start of the week, it felt like I was sleeping and sleeping and sleeping and then never actually feeling rested. But other than my blood pressure, which has come down, it's still higher than is ideal, but it's come down a lot. I was mostly okay. I made a doctor's appointment, which I've had this week, but I'll probably cover that in another video because I'm kind of trying to cover the events of my life chronologically in these chatty videos so that I don't lose track of what I've told you and what I haven't. The first day after half term, we actually had something really nice. We were invited to go into the school to see what they'd been working on. So the previous term, they'd done this geography project. And they'd been studying, well, all sorts of bits of geography around the world, learning about countries and capitals and where things are. I think they called it like the University of the World or something was their bit. My son absolutely loved that because he loves that sort of thing anyway. He's got a really good memory for these things and he's played lots and lots of games about geography and world stuff. So he's actually, he could outdo most grown-ups, to be honest. He's at the point where a lot of countries he can just recognise just by the outline. Like he plays these games, you know, Wordle and then all the offshoots. So this one's like Countryl and there's Worldle. And one of them, I think it's Worldle, you see an outline of a country and you guess what it is. And he'll go on there and he'll be like, oh, that's Syria. And it'll be Syria. And he'll be like, ha. And we'll be like, you realise that most people can't do that right. He's just got them all memorised. So, yeah, he really enjoyed the project. And I got to go in and see what he'd been working on, which was fun. My husband had to work, unfortunately, so he missed it. But I went in. It was funny though, because we all queued up to go in and my son was like, oh, you have to get there at like 22 and then they'll let you in, you can come in at 1:45. So I got there at 22 as I was told to, but it turned out I was quite early on in the queue. So then we all kind of filed into the school and followed the directions to our kids' classrooms. And I was the second parent to reach my son's classroom. So they're all sitting there with their books out, watching and waiting. And with the early people who came in, all the kids are like, it's your mum to each other. So he went bright red and he was really embarrassed. He felt better once other parents came in as well. He was just like, you were really early. You can never do it right, can you? I said to him afterwards, like, you know, I'm sorry you were embarrassed, but you wouldn't have liked it if I couldn't have come. He said, oh, no, not at all. I'd much prefer you were there early than you didn't come. He's only 9, so his embarrassment about his parents hasn't reached the kind of levels that I'm sure it will when he's a teenager. My husband always says that's like his life's ambition, is to be an embarrassing parent. He's well on his way, says my son. The other thing that was exciting, I keep missing drills as well. I'm doing worse than usual for picking out all the drills of a particular colour because I'm far away and I'm distracted. Mind you, this is quite confetti heavy. The whole rest of this canvas that I have still to do is going to be quite heavy in confetti. The middle sections had a fair bit of colour blocking and went quite quickly. But in general, this is a landscape and, you know, landscapes tend to mean one thing. Confetti. So yeah, they started doing swimming lessons at the school. So every Thursday, they take in their swimmers and they get on a coach and they go off to one of the local leisure centres. I don't think it's a leisure centre, it's just a swimming pool. And they're learning to swim. My son can already swim. My husband's taught him because my husband's really into swimming. But he will be able to work on his stamina and get to be a lot stronger. He's been able to swim a bit for quite a while, but he's only quite recently really started getting the hang of it. So it's good timing for him to be able to really build on what he can already do. I'm just going to do a tiny bit more and then I best get myself ready to go out, because I have an appointment in 40 minutes and I have to get over there. I hope the sound's been okay. I sent back the first microphone because I wasn't happy with it, and I've got a different one. I normally film my videos without microphones, and to be honest, I think the sound that my phone picks up isn't bad, but whenever I turn my head away at all, obviously the sound fades out. And it's probably also slightly more likely to pick up background noise. So I thought if I could get an affordable microphone that does a better job, then, you know, brilliant. At first, when I started out with this channel, I didn't really want to buy much because, you know, I didn't know how it would go, if I would stick with it. But now I've been here for a year, I think I'm probably here for the long haul because I'm still really enjoying it. So I don't mind investing a little bit more. Okay. Actually, I should have some lunch before I go out. No, it's a bit too early for lunch. I'll have that when I come back. I need to get some food out to defrost for tonight as well. We're going to have a nice, easy dinner tonight. I've got a jar of Uncle Ben's sweet and sour sauce that I found when I was rummaging around the cupboards last week, and it should have been used by November. So I'm going to use it now while it's still... It's a best before date, so it'll be absolutely fine to still use and probably would be for years to come. But obviously the flavour will deteriorate if I leave it there much longer. So I'll do chicken for me, tofu for my husband, and my son really doesn't like sweet and sour sauce. So I've just got him a macaroni cheese ready meal. Just keeping it nice and easy. Right, I think I will leave that there and go get myself sorted. But thank you for joining me today. I hope that you have made some progress on your WIP, probably more so than me, working at a distance. And yeah, this is the thing with squares. As I was going, I was like, oh, everything's going really wonky because I'm not sitting close enough. But actually the sections that I filled in don't look too bad. I mean, it's on a light pad, so you can probably see wonky bits more so than you would be able to if that was off. But they do kind of fill each other in because, you know, if you've got one that's slightly wonky and you fill in the ones around it all right, they straighten it up. So yeah, that's me for today, and I will see you next time. Bye.